Hello, everybody. All right, so you just looked at the product rule, and now I want you to look at something called the quotient rule. So the product rule would be for a product of two functions, for a function times a function. But what if we want to find the derivative of one function divided by another function? Well, I was going to have you watch another Khan Academy video, because he's very good. But he uses the chain rule to derive this. And you don't know the chain rule. It's for that's for the derivative of f of g of x, a composition of functions. But we'll save that for later. For the quotient rule, I'll just go ahead and give it to you, because you'll probably not remember if I derive it with the chain rule anyway. So I'll show you what it is, and I'll show you a little rhyme to help you remember it. So we're going to have f prime of x times g of x, this is kind of similar to the product rule, minus, instead of plus though, g prime of x times f of x all over g of x squared. Okay? So how do we remember this? It might be a little easier to look at if we use things that are a little shorter, so like u and v, this is really common. So it's u prime v minus v prime u over v squared. That's not the rhyme. The rhyme is, if we call this the high function and the low function, it's a nice little rhyme. Maybe I could write it in a different order here real quick. So we've got v u prime minus u v prime over v squared. So the little rhyme is low d high, the low function times the derivative of the high function minus high, that's the high function, the u, d low over the square of what's below, square of what's below here. So low d high minus high d low over the square of what's below. It's a nice little rhyme to help you remember the quotient rule. Really quickly, I'll have you watch more videos for examples from other guys who have already done the work, so I can get out of here and maybe see my baby born soon. So I'll just show you the derivative of something like the sine of x over x squared plus 2x. Okay? So low d high, low d high, that's low d high, low, just the low function, just the function from the denominator, times d high, the derivative of the top function, the numerator, minus high, okay, that's the high function, the function that's on the top of the function, or the fraction, the quotient, times d low, that's 2x plus 2, over the square of what's below, that's x squared plus 2x squared. We're not really going to be able to simplify this much, so I'll just leave it just like that. Yeah, this is about as good as it's going to get. So we'll just leave it like that, and there you go. That is the derivative of this function, which I think about how far you guys have come in such a short amount of time. You didn't even know what the derivative was. Now you know the derivative is a function that tells you the slope at any x. If I told you to find the derivative of this using the limiting process, it would have blown your mind, and you probably wouldn't have been able to do it. I don't know if I could have done it. But now we have the product rule, the quotient rule, the power rule, the constant multiple rule, the sum and difference rule, all sorts of different rules that allow us to take very complicated derivatives of very complicated functions. So it's pretty cool. So you got the product rule, you got the quotient rule. I'll have a few more videos here just working through some examples. If you have any questions, you can look in the solutions manual and help each other out. But yeah, thanks a lot.